Yes, loud and clear.
All right. Okay, give us the details for tomorrow. You said that you advise the public to come early. Let's talk about that.
Yes, we're anticipating, of course, we have our friends and family, extended family. We've also invited the diplomatic corps and, of course, government officials and former officials who worked with us will be attending. As I mentioned, it is open to the public, so nobody will be turned away, but because of that, there may be a little bit of a crowd. And by the way, we certainly thank the Office of the President, the Armed Forces of the Philippines, and the Philippine National Police for all of their assistance in all of these matters.
Okay. And for those who want to pay their respects tomorrow, is there something they should know? Something like, for example, what they shouldn't carry? Perhaps some safety measures you'd like to share?
Sure. Pack light. It is potentially going to rain as well, so that's another consideration. There will be security protocols, and out of consideration for, you know, the ongoing pandemic, we do encourage everyone to be fully vaccinated, to test if you can before arrival, but I don't believe that there's going to be a pre-testing protocol on site, so please do that at home.
Uh-oh. So there's no pre-testing protocol for anybody who wants to visit?
We're asking all of the guests to please take care of that before they arrive.
All right. And even those who will be visiting last minute tomorrow? Because you are opening this to the public. Are you checking each and every one?
Internment, yes. That's really a matter that's up to AFP, so I'm not... Okay. Clued in on those specific details, but in general, we would encourage everyone, if you have the ability to check before you arrive, that would be very helpful.
All right.
And also help us manage with crowd control.
Okay. But well, Sam, maybe you can share with us the last few days. The family's been overwhelmed with a kind of love, support that's been shown to your grandfather.
Yes, absolutely. And I think, you know, it's a great testament to just what kind of a man FER was, that we've had people come from all walks of life. Everyone knows FER was a military man, but we also have a lot of friends from civil society organizations that came by. Different religious groups have come and paid their respects. We've had all sorts of representation from all, you know, representing all sorts of the political aisle. So FER during his presidency and even before that and certainly after that, he prided himself on being friends with everyone, on working with anyone and everyone, so long as they were willing to get down to work as well. And we really see that here over the last week. As you mentioned, it's been very overwhelming and very heartwarming.
Mm-mm. What was it like for you growing up with him as your lolo?
Karen, I think I will spend the rest of my life really figuring out the answer to that. But, you know, on the one hand, it was kind of crazy. He's a living legend of history. I'm a big history buff. And that's something that I'll cherish for the rest of my life. On the other hand, you know, he was also, when you get behind the achievements and all of the, you know, his public service career, he was also just a man. He was a very warm and funny grandfather. He was very supportive of me and all of my cousins in whatever our pursuits were. I think, you know, one question we've gotten a lot is whether there was any pressure on us to follow his path, either in the military or in politics. And I can say, you know, our family has done a really tremendous job of letting us grow in our own ways and supporting those pursuits, whatever they are. So, you know, whether that's music, or other career choices that aren't necessarily in the military. We don't actually have anyone in the military from our generation, but I think that's okay. And FER, you know, one of the things that he would repeat often to us is that there's so many ways to serve your country, there's so many ways to serve your community, and ultimately that's more important than any role or title.
All right, and what is the biggest lesson that you feel he's taught you?
So I think it's, I'm going to pull up one of his catchphrases, right, which is UST, unity, solidarity, and teamwork. And I think, you know, his life, starting in the military, but through his public service career and certainly afterwards, it just shows how much you can get done if you're united in your purpose, if you're on the same team, and if you are able to, I don't know, put aside petty politics and bickering and get down to the real problems at hand. And something he said during his inaugural address in 1992 is this country has no shortage of problems for us to attend to. And unfortunately, I think that's just as true today as it was 30 years ago. So I think, you know, there's plenty of things we can disagree on as a nation and citizens, but there's also plenty more that we should be able to agree on when it comes to, you know, getting down to the basics of doing the job of governance and supporting our communities to help themselves develop.
Mm. All right. Well, I also wanted to ask, how is Madame Ming Ramos? I know it must have been so hard for her in the last few days, but how is she holding up?
Yes, thank you for asking. She's holding up tremendously well, given the circumstance. You know, Lola has always been strong. In fact, she's always been the stronger of the two. So she's been at the wake, in and out. Obviously, it's hard to pull 12-hour shifts here, so we've been making sure that everyone in the family paces themselves. I suppose of note is that on the first day of the wake, she was here to receive President Marcos, which was a very gracious and warm visit. The two of them had a very nice conversation for about half an hour sitting in the chapel, so we really appreciated that. And, you know, all throughout, I think the other notable thing to mention is the other day my grandmother requested a keyboard. Of course, she's a great musician, and Lola always loved to, you know, bug her to play the piano during our family lunches. So she took it upon herself to bring a keyboard out here and play, and that was very special.
All right. Thank you so much for joining me this morning, Sam. And you take care.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
And that's Head Start.